Hello, I am Jack Sifri, a MMIC design flow specialist at Keysight Technologies. In this short video, I want to show you how you can enhance the performance of your layout by parameterizing it and optimizing it using EM simulation. At the end, I will show you how to download both the design project and a useful document with valuable tips to make your whole EM optimization process fast and efficient. Let me first illustrate the objectives using this 10 GHz amplifier design. This is my initial design using circuit simulation. Notice all specs, the gain, S11 and S22 are met. But with EM simulation, proximity and coupling effects altered the response and I no longer meet the specs. So to fix the design prior going to fabrication, I parameterized it and I performed EM optimization on it in order to bring the response back in spec, as shown here at the right side of the screen. I will come back to this design later and use it to show you the whole EM optimization setup process. First, allow me to share with you a brief overview on mutual inductance and coupling effects. This should help put a good perspective into our topic. Take a look at these four structures of identical spirals with negative mutual inductance. The first two structures on the top are loosely coupled, whereas the other two structures, 3 and 4, at the bottom are tightly coupled. Notice the big variation in their EM simulated inductance. The variation goes as high as 12%, and I'm not even including any statistical variations yet. Look at structures 3 and 4 at the bottom. They are totally identical, except one is horizontal and the other is vertical. Notice their corresponding inductance value, the blue and pink curves. They show a 7% variation. To illustrate this further, I built this simple low-pass filter using the horizontal and vertical orientations, as shown here in red and blue. Both filters are identical, except in the way they are laid out. But look at the response. They have different 3 dB bandwidth and totally different rejection response. This is very important because depending on how you lay out your design could surprise you with output results that don't meet your specification. Let me expand this concept on this MMIC KU band down converter. Look at the spirals with the vertical or horizontal structures. All these structures might end up surprising you when you fabricate your design. For example, let's take a closer look at the two spirals at the input of the power amplifier. An EM analysis was performed on it, and notice how the input return loss response shifted to higher frequency due to the coupling effect of these two vertical spirals. So how do we fix these coupling problems prior to fabrication? The most practical approach is to perform a quick EM optimization on the design and ensure all specs are met prior going to fabrication. So now, let me take you back to the example I showed at the beginning of this video, and let me show you how to perform parameterization and EM optimization on it. This MMIC amplifier has the following specs. The frequency is from 9.5 to 10.5 GHz with 10 dB of gain. The input and output return loss has a visuar of 1.5 to 1, which translates to minus 14 dB. I used a nonlinear demo kit, which has components as shown here at the right side. Please note, these design kit models are individually EM based. They were created with EM simulation for more accuracy, but of course, they do not include the coupling effects. This is the workspace in ADS. I organized my material in 5 folders. Folders 1 and 2 contains the initial design, circuit simulation, and the EM simulation. So if I open the top level schematic, notice that I have my amplifier and it says here schematic. So if I push into this block, it shows me the schematic that I want to simulate. So let me simulate the circuit models of the initial design. Okay, so here's my gain and the return loss, S11 and S22. Everything seems to meet specs. This is the circuit models simulation. Next, let me change this view to simulate the EM. I already have done EM simulation on this initial design, so now I have the EM COSIM view, and if I push into this design, no longer I'll see the schematic, I will have the EM results. All the results have been saved in the database here. So let me simulate the EM, and notice now S11 and S22 are out of specs because of the coupling and the proximity effects in the initial design. So this is why I need to do EM optimization to bring the design back with EM simulation. Folder number 3 contains the parameterization process prior to do EM optimization. So if I open the schematics, the same schematic I showed you before, the first step in the parameterization process is to select the components you want to parameterize. For example, here's capacitor C1, and I called it C equal input matching network C1. And the same here, this length of the line, instead of putting the length, I put L2. I give it a variable name. And I have many other variables selected in the schematic here. And once I do this, I go to File, Design Parameters, and in the Cell Parameter tab, I type in these variables from the schematic and I insert the default value for each. That's all to it. This is how to parameterize your schematic. Once you do this, you open the layout, and if you go to File, Design Parameters, you notice that already it contains the parameters, the cell parameters, because from the schematic, they are already automatically inserted here. The only thing is, I want you to go to View Specific Configuration, and I want you to select the type of artwork from the pull-down menu, Parameterized. You want to select the parameterized artwork. And this is really all to it. I just showed you how to parameterize your design. Now, what's nice about this, now if I go to a top level test bench, like I showed you before, and if I bring this cell that I have parameterized, you notice that on the top level, you will see all these parameters. So they are accessible at the top level, at the cell level. And what's nice about this, because when you go to the variable setup, to set up your variables, you can access them, and you can set the optimization here, the optimization. You can fill in the optimization information right here, and you can check which one you want to optimize. I'll show you that later. Now, let me show you how to set up your design for EM optimization. You open the layout, and the first step is you click on that EM simulation setup, and you can select the EM co-simulation and choose the momentum EM simulator. In the co-simulation tab, notice in the mode of operation, this one here is used if I don't have a parameterized, not parameterized design. But if I do have a parameterized design, I selected include these parameters. I can use them in the optimization process. So I typed in my parameters. So once we do all this here, the setup on the left side, once we finish, all we have to do is generate the views, the EM views. So I click on go, and automatically ADS will generate the EM view that is going to be used in the EM simulation and the EM optimization. And you can see here the EM COSIM view has already been generated for me since I already have done it. So this is what it will use. So once I did the EM setup, then I open the top level schematic, and I have the parameters available. I can set up for the optimization parameters by clicking these, you know, which parameters I want to optimize, EM optimize. I can do all the setup for the optimization here. Also, I will place an optimization controller and my goals for S22, S11, and S21. And once you place these and you set up your variables, everything is ready. When you click on optimize, it will launch EM optimization. It will run the optimizer while running momentum EM simulation at the same time. And let me show you how this is done in the next folder. This is my top level schematic. So now all I have to do is click on this optimization cockpit, and it will launch the optimization as shown, and then the optimization will take place. If you look at that 10 gigahertz amplifier, the one I'm optimizing right now, notice here's my layout, but notice also there is one automatically created from the optimization process. If I open this, this is a working layout, is dynamically changing as the EM optimization is running. Okay, here we go. Watch the layout. Now it's gonna change. You see how it changed? And now it will run the EM optimization until it minimizes the error function and meets the optimization goals. So you can see it is meshing it and running EM momentum simulation and optimization at the same time. So here you can see it took about 3.5 minutes to make the first EM run, and now the error function is calculated. So now the EM simulation, the optimization will keep running, and as it runs, it will change these components discretely. I'm doing discrete optimization. And if you see one of the variable range go all the way up or all the way down, you can always pause it and edit the variables to change the range, and then you can continue with the optimization so you don't have to start all over again. I hope you have found this video useful. See, using EM optimization on your final design is important. It takes account of all the coupling effects and brings the output results in spec prior going to fabrication. Thus, it helps you achieve first pass success. You can download the project file I used along with a useful document that contains valuable tips on how to make your whole EM optimization process fast and efficient by clicking on the link with the red arrow or by using the URL provided at the bottom of the page. Thank you for watching.